Good morning, everyone. This is Erica Swenson Elliott. You can find me at my website of the same name as well. This is April 3rd, 2021. It is the Saturday before Easter. So happy Easter for all of you that are celebrating that a little bit early. Today, I'm going to talk about mudras, and I'm going to talk about from a technology talk perspective. We're going to spend some time on our tech talk about how to use a blog on your own website and incorporate that and what I've learned from that. So I'm starting today on my website. You can see up here at the top with /blog coming over here. You can find the blog in the top menu. So this is a Wix website. So for those of you that are not computer programmers and want to do a lot of it yourself, this is definitely a good way to go. I have a business website as well that's more technical on ClickFunnels, which uses the social media marketing advertising, but I need a technology person to run that for me because it's more programming. So the Wix one, as many of you have probably already found out, is you can do more of it yourself. Even so, I've had a lot of help with my editor publisher who helped me create the format. So it's not so easy to do if it's brand new to you, even if you're technical in other ways on the website. So take your time, be patient and kind to yourself as you're building your own branded communication platform, which many of us are doing now, so we can get our own message and opinion out to others that are interested. So this one I'd like to do today is about mudras. What are mudras? So I'm going to click on that blog right here. This is my original art. I'm a watercolorist, and I like to try to bring, you know, what's in the mind using both sides of the hemisphere, right and left mind, and bring that into the consciousness. So you can see here, this is a little butterfly at sea I did while on a cruise. And you can kind of see down the bottom if you choose to, that there's a little dove down there. So that's a little bit of what do you see, right? A little bit like the Rorschachs, if any of you are familiar with that. So mudras, the world at your fingertips. Many of us intuitively already feel that there is an invisible spiritual world around us and within us. Some of us may already be more connected with this aspect of ourselves, and others might just be waking up to this notion at the writing of this post. I've spent this lifetime developing my own tool belt of varied implements that work for me. This post focuses on mudras, which are a series of ancient yoga postures using only your arms, your hands, and your fingers. Okay, what are mudras? So I'm going to see if I can play this video while we're in the video. See if that works. If I blow up my computer. This is about a year ago I did this intro to mudras. It's about 1 minute long.
Hello, my name is Erica Elliott, and I am a certified mudra therapist.
We can hear
you
that.
You may ask what mudras are. Mudras are very specific movements that only involve your fingers, your hands, and your arms. Therefore, you could say mudras are yoga only with your hands. Mudras are a very ancient practice. There are hundreds of them, and they have been passed down for generations. They are found throughout the world, and all of us know this international sign for prayer. This is actually a mudra. Every mudra is activating and clearing and healing your own energy minds inside of your own body. It is connecting your mind and your heart and your soul with your physical body. Therefore, mudras can be done anywhere, any place, anytime, without any props, any other people, or any other outside stimulus. You are your own healer when it comes to mudras.
Okay, so I think that's good, I couldn't summarize it better than that myself. In the world that we live in today, we're often bombarded with uninvited information through the abundance of technology surrounding us. whether it is through our own or other TVs, computers, and cell phones, it is a virtual torrent. If we do not learn how to manage and separate from this invasion, we, especially the sensitives, can become overwhelmed and unduly influenced by the info stream, even sick. So this one is the protection mudra. So that's basically a crossing of the arms, and I'm going to play that 3-minute video as well. So you can follow along and learn your first mudra if you've never done one before.
This is the mudra for protection. You want to be either sitting or kneeling in a comfortable seated position on the floor or in a chair. You want to have a straight spine, neck long, shoulders down and relaxed, chin level with the floor. The protection mudra is left hand over right and placing them on your upper chest. Palms are facing you and all of your fingers are flat and together. We hold ideally each mudra for 3 minutes at a minimum. So you can set your phone timer when you're doing these by yourself at home. Ideally, you want to do 3 mudras and for a set of 3. Protection mudra, long, deep, and slow breath. You can think about all colors, all chakras, and if you would like to add a mantra, you can do the Om mantra, which is God in his absolute state. So all together, I'm going to inhale a long, deep, slow breath.
You're doing your inhale and your exhale through your nose. And the reason for doing that is it's resetting your parasympathetic system and bringing your adrenaline levels down. So when you breathe through your nose, you're calming your electrical system in your body. This one,
if your eyes gently closed.
I don't want to interrupt the teacher.
If you want to add a prayerful mantra, you could use Om with this one, and we'll do one together. The Om mantra is God in his absolute state. And that is the protection mudra.
So I'm playing you that, first of all, so you can learn it and do, that's a pretty simple one. And that one is a great one, especially for women. I think, hold a lot more negative energy sometimes, take it in through our heart there. And that's a good way to kind of protect yourself when you're going out in the public before do that. That was an example of the 3 minutes. You could buy my mudra course, Intro to Mudras, right here, which is $11 for 12 mudras. That includes the protection mudra. It has the intro video in it. So I started putting that together during COVID last year when we weren't allowed to leave our houses and we were locked in. So I was like, okay, well, I can go, the universe is actually within. I can go inward, which I think is really the journey that we're all supposed to be on right now in some shape or form, is going inward. The other cool thing on the blog that I put in here there's a little meditation that I use a lot. I haven't put that onto a t-shirt yet. I'm protected, I'm provided for, I am powerful. Everything is in its divine working order. So yes, through mudras, the world is at our fingertips, which happens to also be the name of my last water kilner featured in this post. This is the world at her fingertips. My one daughter was a muse for this. She was young, and it was obviously a reference to being on the computer, everything's at your fingertips, but it's also a reference for mudras, is because literally you can go within by using your own hands and your fingertips. This one right here is a little short film that you can click through from the blog that my daughter Chloe made on Vimeo. She did it for a school project. It's about 10 minutes long, so if you're pressed for time, you can come back. I'm going to play it here. I think I have it already up. She did a really good, I of course she's my daughter, so she did, but regardless, even if she was not my daughter, the video to me is, it makes it, turns like the mudras into like an art form as well. It's really kind of slow moving and has a nice tempo to it. Let me click on that here. So she did this about 3 years ago. So about 10 minutes, if you don't have time, you can come back and watch it later.
That there was so much about form, and then every once in a while, I would feel like I had this glimpse of like a feeling of a connection with God, that higher power, the higher consciousness, whatever you're comfortable calling it today. But, and I knew it was real, but it seemed like the real God got lost in all the traditional formations that you feel. And you can spend lots of times in ritual trying to find the God, but it didn't always work. So I felt like you're having this sacred, simpler path. Mudras, how you spell them, definitely came out of the Vedic tradition in India. There's theory, because that's obviously thousands of years old, that the Egyptians took the mudras to India, and then they were captured and written down, and also captured in oral tradition. So there's definitely a thought that they're actually much more ancient and from some higher power that got here to Earth, that maybe these people aren't even here today. There's people that actually believe they came from Atlantis, and they came through Atlantis, went to Egypt, and then went to India. You know, we can't prove any of that. We don't know, because we don't have any written histories. So for me, myself, I don't particularly feel connected that Hinduism is a religion that I care to practice. To me, because it's not part of my own tradition of being raised, but I feel like you're an international, global, accessible signs that all of us can use. And then the other thing about is this praying hands one has gone across all religions.
It's divine worship. It's
interesting that every single religion uses that same one, even though they don't necessarily identify with each other. I prayed for many miracles, and that they didn't really happen. But then other times, and this is kind of interesting about coming into my yoga practice, is with mudras, which is hand yoga. This particular mudra is on higher consciousness. And this mudra will bring and draw things to you that you desire.
It's true.
So I've done this, and things that if you hold this for about 3 minutes, this is at your heart chakra. It's connectivity, it's going outwards, and you can start to kind of feel things coming into you.
This one is strong nerve. nerves. So if you're having energy issues, like nervous energy, this is a way to calm it down. It's also good for allergies. So third finger, pinky on the right, touching your thumb. That's
about the crown 10 years chakra. Ago, I had caused a lot of damage in my knees from playing sports and injuries when I was a teenager. And I literally kind of stumbled or crawled into the hot yoga room in West Palm Beach, Florida, because of my knees. And kind of the interesting thing about knees and divine study is that they represent ambition, and they also represent humility. So like when our knees don't work, we're humble and we kneel. And so in Christian worship and other forms of worship, kneeling down, so that's like a sign of humility. So it's all about knees. So my physical pain in my knees brought me to yoga. And for those of us in America aren't really familiar, but yoga is actually a form of worship. It's about union, and it's about connecting our body to our minds, to our soul, to our spirit. So about 10 years ago, I started my expansion of my spirituality and connecting my body to God.
This is developing meditation.
Before I knew anything about mudras, I was really suffering from asthma and allergies. I took a lot of medication, and I had prayed many times to be healed from asthma. And this one time, there was a man in church who was pretty old at the time. He was probably 70, and he's still alive today. He's close to 100. He had like some kind of gift of healing. And so he did a very simple prayer, but you can kind of feel this energy coming out of his hands, which I now like understand and recognize more from the yoga study that I've done. But his hands would like have heat come out of them. And so one time he came to the teenage Bible study, and he said, well, has anyone on to have prayer for healing? And so I'm like, for like the 100th time, I'm like, okay, I wanna not have to take asthma medicine anymore. And I asked Uncle Bob to pray for me, and I could feel, I literally felt like this hot, like a laser go in about right here, and it was like, it was like a little bird and seal, and then that was, I then went home and I never touched those really bad pills again.
Crazy, right? But in a good way. I wish I had those jeans still. If you're my favorite, I ripped them apart. I wore them out.
Every single one of us has that still small voice that tells us, yes, that's a whisper, do this, do that. And sometimes when we're listening to the music, have the TV on, watching the news, all the chatter around us, we are suppressing that still small voice in us. So by taking even just 5 minutes, at some time when there's no friends around, there's no family, by yourself, and no it's a God, and getting quiet and still, start to connect with that voice. And that voice is really divine. You might not believe that yet, but the more you listen to that still small voice and act upon it, you will start to realize you're raising your own consciousness and you're connecting to that God voice. Right, you know it's right, and often we say, oh, why didn't I do that? I knew I should have done that. And that's what we're talking about today in this busy world. Is we heard this in small ways and we chose to be right. So it's never too late, never too old to start again.
So I haven't watched that in a while, so oh, yeah, this is Chloe now talking.
Strange to me how your hands and your own body and your own being can influence your life and your religious touch. The way we move our bodies can orchestrate so much and extend our reach to whatever God we believe in. But in this case, my mom's case, the God in Christianity. Mudras bridge the gap of you and the divine with the traditional chaos form beneath. It's a trustworthy homeopathic approach that never fails and you can feel within you.
Should have put a little New York skyline in there. Central Park. I don't go to New York. This is her daughter's perspective.
So it's very, I feel like the thing I've learned is that like the secret really is in our hands. And in ourselves, and through our hands of meditation, we can connect with the divine in ourselves.
I think that's it. I'll let her play out so she gets her little credits at the end. So you can get to that Vimeo link through my blog on my website again. And then this one at the bottom, the last thing in the post is the Intro to the Mudras course. If you clicked on the Endeavor University, that's where I'm gonna be putting more digital content for technical training as well, from like the tax CPA side of my life, as well as mudras and maybe some art stuff as well. But that's what this course would look like. So. That's reference to my teacher there, Sabrina Mesko. Okay, so we did enough about mudras today. The other thing I wanted to talk about is this is one of my original art of tax shirts, one of my designs. And if you can see it here on the shop, this one makes me laugh. Makes me really happy. So if you came to my shop, which you can get to through the website. I have links in the video as well. Go to the t-shirts. This is I've been like obsessed with these rash guards. They're really high quality, like held up well in the wash. They have 38 to 40 UPF. I think these are off of the Printful is the plugin into the Shopify is like their one of their products. If you have your own store and you want to make some rash guards on yours. So this is the one I'm wearing today, the Women's Rash Guard Art of Tax t-shirt. So this was all of the little tax terms after my career in US taxation. I'm doing this too, because I want you to, all those of you that are in the business world that are bored and want to expand your horizons. There's so many ways, like each of us are very deep people, souls, and there's so many things that we're powerful and capable of doing. So regardless of what people around you say, you can do many things. And I am some living proof for you to see that if you're still trying to find your way. It took me a long time. It took me about 15 years to like connect all the different aspects and figuring out who I really was instead of what other people wanted me to be. So here's a little blurb about this shirt. After a career in US taxation, she's keenly aware of the undue burden that overtaxation creates. As we know, a picture is worth 1,000 words. So if we see many types of taxation as well as tax definitions all combined into one image, it is very powerful. The burden of taxation on taxpaying citizens becomes quite clear. And taxation can become a form of art too, almost a tattoo on the skin of the taxpayer. Intense, yet true. So for example, federal income tax, FIT, estate tax, death tax, state income tax, AMT, which is alternative minimum tax, FEIE, which is the foreign earned income exclusion for US taxpayers that are living abroad. And yes, if you're not living in the United States, but you're a US citizen, you are required to file a tax return every year, report all income, but you do get an exclusion, like I think about $190,000 now a year. But if you don't file, that you can end up losing the exclusion. So you gotta go back and get on record there. That's you, et cetera, et cetera. So that's my little tax tip for the day. And you can hopefully be as amused as me. I think my CPA friends are the ones who are gonna like this, people that were doing taxes for other people. So enough about that. I wanna show you one thing with the IRS. I'd like to try to do a little tax tip every day. This web, we talked about the IRS.gov website the last 2 days. So I'm coming back to it one more time here. As a taxpayer, a US citizen, it is an easier way for you to manage your own life. And if you're trying to figure out where the heck your first, second, third stimulus payment is, I've heard there's all kinds of different timing, and it's tied somewhat to your tax return. So you can check your refund status to figure out, you're going to need your social security number, what amount you're looking for, when did you file the last return. You can also put this cool app on your phone by clicking here, IRS to go app. You can find it on your iPhone, Samsung. Excuse me, I have the hiccups. So you can make payments on there, which is great if you're self-employed. You don't really need to do that if you're withholding, from your W-2. And yes, everything's screwed up right now because of COVID. And apparently, I think the IRS is going through a big shakedown. The tax code keeps changing. You have to update systems. So everything's taking longer. People are getting notices that for things that were filed 6 or 9 months ago, and then they freak out, but then they get another notice saying, okay, it's actually found and it's accepted. So the notices that come from the IRS are very computer generated, AI generated, not individually sent to you. So it takes a while for all the systems to match up. So stay calm if you're getting notices that seem to be on delay. Okay, so I think we did that. I think one thing I usually focus on a book. I just started a book for if you want to blow your mind. If you've never heard of Carrie Cassidy, this is her website. She's been around, she's interviewed over 1,000 whistleblowers, a lot of them military. And this book that just came out is like her summary of her life's work. So Rebel Gene is the name of the book, and it's tied into DNA, which is interesting because it's definitely running parallel to my next novel that I'm going to be publishing, hopefully sooner rather than later, is the March novel. And that one is going to be the third in the series here, which is past life, reincarnation, time travel. The March novel is going to be about giants, the ancient giants that have been skeletons that have been found across the world, particularly in North America. And where did they go? What happened to all of those skeletons that were found? You can see this if you follow the History Channel at all. There's some TV shows on that. But a lot of them went into the Smithsonian like 1900, and we've never seen them again. So Indian myths, the Native American myths, basically say that these were people that were here before them. The ancient ones is what the natives called them. So that's very intriguing to me as well. So she kind of gets into that a little bit in her book. So I'm going to promote her here. She's been out there on the front lines, truth-telling, when all of us were, busy working away at our computers and our desks. And the other thing I want to promote as well is, this is a subscription channel, the Optimized Tribe. I've talked about the last 2 days as well. This is Michael Jaco, who's a retired Navy SEAL, 26 years. 12 years, I think, in the CIA, has all kinds of special op stories. He's been out there, and Jay Campbell, a partner on this community tribe, where stuff that you can't necessarily find anymore out in the public domain, you pay a monthly subscription, not only do you have access to those chants, to those videos, and people like, that's how I found Carrie Cassidy, was through the Optimized Tribe, and you can access those videos, have a community forum to talk about, and kind of, you know, encourage you to connect and find out new information. Another thing I just found on there, which I'm very excited about, I think this is my last tech talk thing for the day, is I found this, Lightwater. And you can go to this website yourself if you want. I found that through the Optimized Tribe. And it is very cool. It's like if you're a techno physicist kind of person, you'd be interested in this drones. I don't know if I'm gonna get it. I'm gonna show you one like crazy thing that happens. Lightwater Scientific. It's deuterium, and I'm terrible about pronouncing this. Deuterium depleted water. And I can't explain it very well, so you're gonna have to go find out for yourself. But it's a very heavily processed. It's definitely better to drink than regular water, and I'm not gonna let all these little things beep. But those are the kind of cool things you can find inside of the tribe. And I know this video got a little long today because I'm trying to do more like 25 minutes, but I wanted to play that Mudra video for you and say, tell you again, we're all here in service to each other. When we create, we are serving humanity. And when we help others, we are actually helping and healing ourselves. So how are you going to connect, and how are you going to create, and how are you going to expand? So till next time, have a great one. See if I can stop the little thing, the little recording. Bye.